sudden death. In Arabic it's called موت الفجأة أو موت الفجاءة. Sudden death. Sudden death is someone slept and never woke up. Someone left the house, got into a car accident and died. Someone drowned suddenly. Someone got an accident and a wall fall on him. Sudden death. Many people think that sudden death is something bad, something evil. Because they heard that there are some ahadith that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم sought refuge from sudden death. There's a hadith that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, or he made isti'adha, he sought refuge from seven death, and one of them is maut al-faj'a. But this ahadith and the majority of the ahadith about isti'adha from maut al-faj'a are weak. The majority of the ulama said these ahadith are very weak hadith, and there's no isti'adha from maut al-faj'a. Because maut al-faj'a, sudden death, depends, it varies, it's a case by case. Like Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, موت الفجأة رأفة بالمؤمن وأسف على الفاجر. The sudden death is mercy to the believer and regretful for the wicked. So if a person was doing his best to obey Allah Azza wa Jal and living and practicing Islam, and all of a sudden he died suddenly. Allahu Akbar. He saved all the, you know, the hardship of death, going to the hospital, staying 3-4 months, and all the pain on the family. That's a rahmah for that person. But a person who is suffering and is struggling with his ibadat and not even obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and sudden death came to him, that's a tragedy. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that this sudden death, when it becomes prevalent, and which is, subhanAllah, and this is what brought up this topic. Brother from New York called me, you know, brother so-and-so. I said, yeah, 43 years old. He slept, he did not wake up. That's what reminded me, subhanAllah. May Allah have mercy on him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when it becomes prevalent, it's a sign of the day of judgment is getting closer. One of the signs of the day of judgment is getting closer is that many people are dying sudden death, just like that. Oh, he was with us yesterday, he was with me, gone. Tayyib, how can we prepare ourselves for sudden death, right? What should we do? Few things, inshallah ta'ala. Number one, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us to have the wasiyyah, your will, ready all the time. Because in general, the human being, he is always very hopeful. I'm still young, and I'm doing this, I'm doing that. In 10 years, I'm doing there, and I'm going here, I'm retiring in there. You know, have the wasiyyah ready, and the hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim, that you should check up on your wasiyyah every 2 nights. What does that mean? That means, يعني, I wrote down in my will, I have an apartment so and so. Then I sold it. Check up. Take that out. I borrowed money from so and so and I paid it off already. Make sure you take it out. I lend somebody some money and he paid it off. Take it out. So frequently keep checking on your will. So that shows that alhamdulillah, I am ready if death comes. Second, frequent tawbah. Always make tawbah. Always ask Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive you. And like we said many, many times before, many people think that tawbah is only for the sinners. But Allah Azza wa Jal, He told the believers, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, tubu ila Allah. O who you believe, دو توبة الله وتوبوا إلى الله جميعا أيها المؤمنون. Repent, do tawbah to Allah, all of you believers. And like we always repeat, the minute you think that you do not need a tawbah, you need a tawbah. From that thought. So we constantly make tawbah, and keep in mind that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the tawbah is always valid until, subhanallah, we're talking about sudden death, until you gharghir. Until, Ya Allah, he's about to die, say that I repent now, too late. Inni tubtu al-an, it's too late. And third, أكثروا من ذكر لا إله إلا الله. Always, Ya Akhwan, subhanallah, very light on the tongue, very rewarding, لا إله إلا الله, all the time. Because we know that man kana akhir kalamahu la ilaha illallah dakhala al-jannah. Whomsoever his last words are la ilaha illallah, he will enter jannah. So constantly remember la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, all the time, all the time. Make it a habit, make it a habit to say the word la ilaha illallah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the hadith in Ibn Majah, he said, لا إله إلا الله وحده. لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله وحده. لا إله إلا الله لا شريك له. لا إله إلا الله له الملك وله الحمد. لا إله إلا الله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Those five. They all start with لا إله إلا الله. You just change the last word. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, listen carefully, يا أخوان. Anybody who wants them, please let me know. Whomsoever, من رزقهن, من رزقهن. Look at this. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم called it a rizq. He called it a rizq. من رزقهن عند موته لن تمسه النار. Whomsoever says them on his deathbed, the nar, the hellfire will not touch him. But how he's going to say them if it was sudden death? By constantly repeating them. Anytime you have an opportunity, لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله وحده. لا إله إلا الله لا شريك له. لا إله إلا الله له الملك وله الحمد. لا إله إلا الله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. May Allah give us all a good end. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our last deeds our best deeds and our last words لا إله إلا الله. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما إن الذين يؤذون الله ورسوله لعنهم الله في الدنيا والآخرة وأعد لهم عذابا مهينا والذين يؤذون المؤمنين والمؤمنات بغير ما اكتسبوا فقد احتملوا بهتانا وإثما مبينا.